So I'm just going to go through a couple of more little examples just to make sure you got some opportunity to get really comfortable with this. So like, check this out. Just predict what the outcome of this code would be. Don't actually run the code, okay? Please don't run the code. Try to figure it out on your own. Try to remember what expand and factor do. So pause the video, try to figure this out on your own. Now, we'll assume that happened because you're an amazing student. You would never, ever, ever not do what you're told. So we have x squared minus y squared times x minus y. Now, I'm going to multiply that out because that's what expand means. Expand means go ahead and multiply it out. So I'm going to go x squared times x, which is x cubed, and then x squared times negative y, so minus y x squared, and then minus y. So I'm just foiling it. That's all I'm doing. It might be more obvious if I do that. I'm just going to foil it. So y squared minus x. And then plus, right, because a negative times a negative is a positive, plus y cubed. So if I expand it, I would expect to see that. So let's run it and check. There we go. So x cubed minus x squared y minus xy squared plus 3, or y cubed. Okay? Now if I'm going to factor this, whenever I look at the expanded version, I can probably see, if I've had enough experience with algebra, well, then I'm going to get kind of exactly what I already had. So I have x squared minus y squared, so that should be x minus y, x plus y, and then x minus y again. So, because the difference between two squares is x minus, or the square thingies, plusy and minusy. So x minus y squared, and then x plus y. So that's what I want to see, hopefully, whenever I factor it. Yay! Okay, that was good. All right, now try this one. Remember to pause the computer. Pause the computer. Can't pause the computer. Pause the code. Pause the video. There we go. Pause the video. Give it a shot. See how far you can get. Okay, we'll pretend that happened. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to multiply this out. So I have z equals x squared plus 2 times xy minus 2 times x, because it's 2x times y and 2x times minus 1. And then x, or that thingy, is y squared minus 2y plus 1. So if I'm going to collect the terms in terms of x, that means I'm going to collect all the xy thingies together. So the coefficient of that is x squared. The coefficient in front of the x thingy is 2y minus 2. Those are coefficients in front of the x. And then the coefficients in front of the constant are y squared minus 2y plus 1. Because I'm collecting by x's. Now another option is I could collect by y's. If I'm collecting by y's, I've got a y squared, and then I'm looking for coefficients in front of the y. So coefficients in front of the y are 2x is in front of the y, and there's a minus 2 in front of the y, and then the remaining values are 2x and a plus 1. I'm going to run that, and if I check, that is precisely what I got. And then I wrote this, and then it wrote that. But those are the same thing, so that's cool. So we've kind of talked about the simple function before, and to me, the most fantastic function is simple because it does try all the options. And so, like, if I actually work this out, I get, x squared. Wait, this is the one I just did. this thing. And so I get this, and I'm like, yay, and whatever. There's my answer. And I look at this as like a normal person, and I'm like, I don't know. There's probably a way to simplify this, but I just don't want to think that hard. And so I go, simple. And it's like, oh, it's just that. And you're like, whoa, really? That's amazing. I don't know if I believe you, but I'm going to try it. So I'm gonna check. And this should be the same thing. So it's supposed to be this. So if I have that times that, then I'm going to go x times everything, so that's x squared plus xy minus x, and then y times everything, so that's plus xy plus y squared minus y, and then negative 1 times everything, so negative x, negative y, and plus 1. And so that's x, let me collect all the x's. So x squared plus all the coefficients of x are, well, the x, 2xy, so I have two y's. Well, maybe I'll do that first. I have x squared plus 2xy minus x minus x, so that's minus 2x. Isn't it fun watching other people do algebra? Plus y squared minus 2y plus 1. And I think this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms. And then if I collect by the x's, which is what I kind of did on one of them, I have x squared. And then the coefficient in front of the x is 2y minus 2. And then I have that y minus 1 squared thing, which is 2y minus 2. That's exactly what I had before. So that's kind of amazing that that turned out to be simplified to that. And that's why symbolic algebra is amazing. And you can see all the different ways it does it. So my favorite game, because I get lonely sometimes, is to play Can You Beat the Simple Function? And so I say you'll never actually beat it. That's not entirely true. I know that the cosine squared of x plus the sine squared of x is equal to 1. But it's kind of fun to see all the different ways that MATLAB tries to do it. So it's like, I'm going to rewrite it in terms of sinh and cosh. I'm going to rewrite everything in terms of tangent. And I'm like, I can see how this could actually be useful if I was trying to like manually integrate something and be like, wow, this is amazing. So that's kind of fun. This one is kind of cool. So cosine squared minus sine squared, you might not remember that. That's actually an identity, which is cosine of 2x. That is an identity for sure, cosine 2x. So, but you can actually rewrite it again in terms of tangents and sinhs and coshes and exponentials. It's just crazy. So that's also kind of fun to play around with. Stuff like this is kind of crazy. And you're like, but how could this be? And I think I want to try to work this one out because I want to figure this out. So I was looking at this. And because I fundamentally refuse to let MATLAB win, I have to figure out how to do it. So I'm going to do this for funsies on the side. So I have arc cosine of x. So really I have 3 arc cosine of x. And I'm going to pretend that this is y. So really what I'm looking for is cosine of y. So my goal is to find what is cosine of y, where y is equal to 3 times the arc cosine of x. All right, so no big deal. So I go, okay, well that means that y over 3 is equal to arc cosine of x. So that means that x is equal to the cosine of y over 3. Or cosine of y over 3 is equal to x. And that means that's x. Adjacent over hypotenuse. So I'm going to arbitrarily assign adjacent is 1 and hypotenuse is x, or adjacent is x and hypotenuse is 1. So if this is my cosine of y over 3, the adjacent side is that, this side is this. And so this side here, the opposite side, adjacent over hypotenuse, that's got to be 1 squared minus x squared, like that. Okay, so that's opposite. So that means I can go ahead and I can write sine of y over 3 is equal to, you had no idea you're getting to this, did you? Opposite over hypotenuse. This is super fun, though. 1 minus x squared over 1, so I can just say that that's square root of 1 minus x squared. Okay, so, but what I really want is the cosine of y, and all I know is the cosine of y over 3. So I guess what I can do is I can ask for the cosine of y over 3 plus 2y over 3. And because I'm kind of awesome at life, I know that the cosine, where am I write this? I know that the cosine of a plus b is equal to cosine a, I think it's sine b minus, cosine. And then minus sine a. So I'm going to use that. So I've got cosine y over 3 times the cosine of 2y over 3 minus the sine of y over 3 times the sine of 2y over 3. And I'm like, yay, because I actually know some of these, right? Because I know that the cosine of y over 3 is equal to x. So now it's just x times the cosine of 2y over 3. I'm going to be as smart as MATLAB, I swear. And sine of y over 3 is the square root of 1 minus x squared. And the sine is, 2 sine of 2 y over 3. I don't know what that is yet. Alright, but I can break these up again, because algebra is amazing. So I can say cosine of y over 3 plus y over 3 minus this times the sine of this. No, nothing. The sine of this. And I know, because again, remember I'm amazing, that the sine of a plus b is the sine of a cosine of a plus, or cosine of b, plus the sine of b cosine of a. Yay! Okay, so that's x, and this is the cosine thing again. So it's big, big bracket thing. Cosine y over 3, cosine y over 3, minus sine y over 3, sine y over 3. This is so exciting watching other people's algebra. I think I've said that like 6 times. 1 minus x squared, big bracket. This is really just, since these are the same, a equals b, that means it's sine, 2 sine a cosine b. So that way, cosine a cosine b, like that. Just twice the same thing. So it's 2 sine y over 3 cosine y over 3. Alrighty. So cosine of y over 3 is x. And cosine of y over 3 is x. And sine of y over 3 is that square root of thingy. And sine of it is the square root of thingy. And then there's this. And then there's 2 times the square root of thingy. And then that thing. So woohoo! X cubed minus x times 1 minus x squared minus this thingy. Well, that's 2 times x, and that gets multiplied all together. 1 minus x squared. This is actually kind of amazing. So that's x cubed minus x minus plus x cubed minus 2x plus 2x cubed. Holy Janalama. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4x cubed minus 3x. Proving against any shadow of a doubt that I am indeed as smart as MATLAB if I get to continually pause my video every time I make a mistake and fix it. So this is exactly what MATLAB got, which is amazing because it took me, you know, like a half an hour to get here. And MATLAB was just like, pah, I got this. So this is really, really, really fun.